So, as you can see, this harmonic series without one goes to infinity, and this right here is the classic proof of it. Why is that proof and not simply, if you add infinitely many positive numbers, you get positive infinity? Well, this right here is the bizarre part when we are dealing with infinite series. And let's review the harmonic series again. 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 4, so on, forever. Have a look. 1 half is 1 half, and then you see that 1 third, we can replace that by greater than 1 over 4. Because 1 third is certainly greater than 1 over 4. So I'm just replacing this with 1 over 4, and then we have the greater than. And then in fact, we can do the same thing for these three numbers. 1 over 5 is greater than 1 over 8. 1 over 6 is greater than 1 over 8. 1 over 7 is also greater than 1 over 8. 1 over 8 is 1 over 8. And the next, 1 over 9 is greater than 1 over 16. And then so on. Now check this out. This right here is going to be the following, because here we have the 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4 is just 2 over 4, which is 1 over 2. And then we have 4, 1 over 8. Add them up is 4 over 8, which is 1 over 2. And then from 1 over 16, well, that came from 1 over 9 is greater than 1 over 16, up to 1 over 16. We will have 8 of the 1 over 16s. Add them up, we get another 1 half. As you can see, this process will keep on going forever. So we are just adding infinitely many 1 halves. And then we end up with infinity. And now, it's like, we'll just keep adding fractions. Shouldn't we just get infinity regardless, right? But check this out. It does not happen like that all the time. If today we only have, let's say, 1 over 2, and then we are going to add it with 1 over 4, and then the next one, 1 over 8, and then 1 over 16, and so on. This right here is an example of a geometric series, because each every time we go to the next fraction, we just multiply by a common ratio. In this case, when we go from here to here, we multiply by 1 half. When we get from 1 over 4 to 1 over 8, we multiply by 1 half, and then multiply by 1 half, and so on. Well, I will tell you, when we add up all these fractions, we end up with a whole number, 1. How is this possible? Because right here, we are also adding infinitely many fractions. Well, here's the deal. All these right here, they are just all 1 halves, right? So when you add up all 1 halves, you get infinity. But these right here, yes, they are getting smaller and smaller. But wasn't this one getting smaller and smaller as well though? Here, let me show you. I'm not going to use the formula like the first term divided by 1 minus the common ratio. I will show you this way. Instead of convincing you guys that this will add up to 1, I will do it backwards. I'm going to start with 1 and then break it down for you. Here is a story. Let's say you have a piece of amazing cookie. And let's say this cookie is in the shape of a square, like so. This cookie is so amazing. You really don't want to finish the whole cookie today, because otherwise you don't have that cookie anymore tomorrow. So here's a strategy. For today, please just break it down into 2 pieces and just eat the first half. Tomorrow comes, again, do not finish the whole thing. Break it into 2 pieces again, and then eat half of the half, which is a quarter. The third day comes, again, do not finish the whole thing. Just again, break down into 2 pieces, and then just eat half of a quarter, and you have 1 over 8. And then, the next day comes, you know the deal. Break down into 2 pieces, and then just eat half of 1 over 8, which is 1 over 16. And so on. Can this keep on going forever? Yes, this cookie will last you forever, for infinitely many days. Yes, true that, but like, I don't know if we have infinitely many days. But anyway though, have a look. Let's keep track of how much cookie that we're eating. 1 over 2, and then the next day is 1 over 4, and then 1 over 8, and then 1 over 16, And the next one, I just didn't write it down, but it would be 1 over 32, 1 over 64, and so on, so on, so on. When we add up all these pieces, it must be equal to 1, right? Why? Because it came from one piece of a cookie right here. So, as you can see, when we have infinitely many fractions, when we're adding them up, yeah, we might not get infinity all the time. This right here is equal to 1. In fact, this is really, really crazy. Right here, I will give you guys the alternating version of that as well in the next video.